It's foolish, in my view, to have a referendum in out when actually it would be better for Britain to say we're in, but now let's reform Europe together. I mean, some of the pro-European thought I wasn't pro-Europe enough, but I was under constant attack for being pro-European. I personally think the issue of immigration is probably more important than the issue of Europe in the support of UKIP. And that's a problem everywhere. You know, it's a problem in France, a problem in Germany, a problem in Sweden. Well, it's not my position to give advice, but what I would say from my own experience is this. When you propose the change, everyone tells you it's a bad idea. When you're doing the change, it's hell. And after you've done it, you wish you'd done more of it. It's a very unwise thing in politics ever to have a favorite person, because you make one friend and a lot of enemies. What is important is to demystify this issue of the third way, what it is, and your values remain absolute and unchanged. Your method of application has to change with the world. It's literally as simple a principle, and it's obvious. You can never say you never regret any decisions. There are lots of things in hindsight we would have done differently. And look, I've never denied responsibility for taking the decision. Supposing we hadn't done that in 2003. Okay, you can say you made a mistake, you shouldn't have done it. You'd have what's going on in Syria now, going on in Iraq. Right, that is, the lesson of Afghanistan and Iraq is not, again, complicated, it's simple. It's when you get rid of the brutal regime, then you've got to manage the aftermath. And managing the aftermath is hard and it's long and it's difficult. That is also the lesson of the Arab Spring.